Welcome to the virtual learning course, Optimizing Asset Analytics for Better Performance. My name is David Black, and I'm a technical advisor in the OSIsoft Delivery Services Group. For those of you who haven't worked with our Delivery Services Group before, we work with customers to help them in areas such as architecture, solution planning, training, and challenging technical problems. Over the past year or so, I've worked with several customers who are experiencing performance problems with their asset analytics implementations. For several of those customers, I was able to work with them to determine which analytics were causing problems and to help them optimize those analytics to provide better performance. When speaking with my coworkers in the delivery services group, I found that several of them had encountered customers with similar problems. This course grew out of a desire to take some of the insights that I gained through working with customers and share that knowledge with a larger audience, with the hope that users can troubleshoot their own analytics and know where to focus their efforts. OSIsoft technical support and delivery services are always available to help, but if users can narrow it down to specific questions, it often works better all around. Asset Analytics is an extremely powerful tool that has excellent performance and scalability. It is a reasonably easy tool to learn, and the one-to-many nature of AF templates makes it easy to apply analytics to a wide range of assets. However, with the functionality of Asset Analytics comes the potential to overload the PI system. The asset analytics system itself, though very scalable, does not scale infinitely. The interconnected nature of the PI system and its components, and the volume of data involved, also mean that upgrading the hardware may not solve the problem, even if it helps mitigate it somewhat. Making the analytics more efficient is always beneficial and has worked well for the customers that I have worked with. So we know that making the analytics more efficient is almost always the best solution. The next question is, where do I spend my efforts at optimization? A mature asset analytics implementation may have hundreds or thousands of analytics templates spread across thousands of elements. How do we know which analytics to focus our efforts on? We can look at the performance data for individual analytics in PI System Explorer, but looking at hundreds or thousands of analytics in that fashion is not practical. Instead, we will take this data and analyze it, and then know where best to spend our efforts. The most important outcome of this course is learning to access, export, and analyze the analytics performance data. Anything past that is a bonus that may help with your particular analytic issues. The course manual contains detailed instructions on how to extract the performance data, so make sure to save a local copy to use when analyzing your own asset analytics implementation. The remainder of the course will teach some methods for optimizing analytics based on real customer situations. These techniques may be applicable to certain analytics in your system that you discover need optimization.